two, three, funk it.
Hey guys, welcome to welcome back to the channel, and I hope you guys are having a good day. In today's video, I'm going to go over some series circuit practice questions, and without further ado, let's just get started. Okay, so I kind of sort of didn't get number one, but it was basically just a question about what a series circuit looks like, and I mean, you can just look that up and figure that out. They're just those circuits that are all the way connected to each other. There's no other paths for electricity to flow through other than one path. So, yeah. So, number two, though, is asking the equivalent. So, the total resistance for the circuit below. And in a series circuit, you can get total resistance. You can get total voltage, but you cannot get a total current. Your current is going to be the same throughout in your series circuit. So that means whatever your current is at one point is what it's going to be throughout. So there's not really a total current because it's the same throughout the whole path. So keep that in mind. But for number two, your total resistance, all you have to do is add both of your resistance. So 2 + 5 = 7. So your total resistance is 7. Since there's only two resistance and stuff, so 2 + 5 = 7. 7 ohms. Number 3. Determine the equivalent total resistance for the circuit below. In this case, you have 3 different points for resistance. The first one is 2 ohms, then 5 ohms, then 7 ohms. If you have 2 + 5 + 7, you get 14 ohms. And that's your answer. Number 4 is asking you to determine the total voltage for the circuit below. And again, all you have to do is add to get your total. So first one, 3, then 4, then 6. If you add those together, you get 13 voltage. Number 5, again with the total voltage, you only have 2 this time, so 6 + 6 = 12. And then, this is, okay, I'm gonna read it. In the series circuit, there is just one path, so the charge flow is constant everywhere. Charge is not lost or gained. Circuit B was made by adding 2 identical resistors in series to circuit A. How is the charge flow out of the battery and back into it affected by adding more bulbs in the series? So here's the thing. You know that bulbs are like loads on your circuits. So whatever you add to a circuit that takes away from it for its own good. So if I add something and it's taken away from me for its own good, then it's a load. So same thing with a circuit. So your charge flow or current is going to decrease as the total resistance increases. So your resistance can also be known as a load. So the more you add to it, so the more it goes up and increases, the less the charge flow is going to be because it's taken away from it for its own good. So the motor in like an electric razor, the more motors you add, the less charge. Yeah, the less charge flow or current, if that makes any sense. So yeah, I'm trying to explain it as best as I can, and that's the best I can do. So, number 7. Now I'm going to do a little bit of math. Using a chart to help solve what is the total resistance. So you have R1, R2, and R3. You just add it all together. 10 plus 20 plus 30, 60 ohms. Easy as that. Number 8. What is the total current for the circuit? Again, I told you guys there's not really a total current, so whatever the current is at one point is the same all throughout the circuit. So hear me out. We know your total, and again, all of these charts are going to be the exact same thing, so it's kind of just like going to flow. It's the same exact chart for all of the questions, so don't worry about that. We got resistance at 60, and we know voltage is 6, so we can find current. So if you're trying to find current, we know that current is voltage divided by resistance. So 6 divided by the total resistance, which is 60, will give you 0.1 amps, which is your current. So again, make sure you use your formulas to your own advantage and you know your formulas because they're really going to help you a lot with these problems. So number 9, what is the current for R1? If we just solve the current and we figured out that it's 0.1 for the total, again, it's going to be the same current all throughout the whole circuit. So at every single position, your current is going to be 0.1. So This one's asking for R2. The next one's asking for R3. It's always going to be 0.1. Don't worry about it. Number 12. What is the voltage for R1? So we know that resistance is 10, 20, 30, 60. Current is 0.1, 0.1, 0.1, 0.1. And we know the total voltage is 6. If we're looking for a voltage at R1, we know that voltage is, I think voltage is I times R. So you just multiply your current by your resistance, I believe. So if you multiply the missing spot for R1 is, I mean for I1. Okay, I'm confusing myself. Current at position 1 is 0.1 all throughout. So 0.1 times 10 is 1. So the voltage for R1 is 1. Number 13. At position 2, your voltage is missing. Your current is 0.1, and for resistance is 20. 20 times 0.1 is 2 voltage. This one is for R3. Again, voltage is missing, current is 0.1, and your resistance is 30. 30 times 0.1 is 3, so your voltage is 3. If you were to add all those together, your final, your total voltage would be 6. I really hope I didn't confuse anybody there because the charts aren't filled out. But, yep, that's it. I'm gonna insert a picture of a completed chart so you guys can kind of see, and I hope I didn't confuse anybody, and I hope you learned something new, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye!